This is my Raspberry Pi 5, and ever since I installed the NVMe top hat, it's been running naked like this without a case. That's because the original Raspberry Pi case doesn't fit, and the aftermarket ones are hit or miss. That's until I noticed this little guy, the Argon NEO 5 NVMe case. Let's check it out. Let's have a look at what's inside the box. This is a very tight fit. Inside we will have a manual and the case that is a three-part component. So we have the bottom part. This is also the NVMe top, some pads. This is the middle with a fan, and of course the top part of the case. Let's try to assemble. We're gonna take the Raspberry Pi 5 and put everything together. Now we need to connect the cable. The copper should be facing the white side according to the instructions, so it should be connected like this. That's all the way that it goes in. Keep it push a little bit and then clip it in. Okay, that's connected. Drop in the Pi inside the NVMe case. Now we need to see how we're gonna route these cables, because I don't want them to be too visible. This was the most difficult part. Make sure that the cable is routed by this side and back in. This is not very easy, but anyway, let's move on. Now we will need to get this cable back out. I'm guessing through this small slot over here, like this. Turn it around. It's still not held in place by anything, and we should connect it to the NVMe hat. So I'll continue doing that. Now I'll need to close it like this. Make sure don't catch the wire like I did. And we can now secure it in place with 4 screws. If we follow directly the instructions, we'll need to remove this plate over here that should hide the NVMe drive. This is my old NVMe drive that I was using, so I'm gonna need to move this a little bit more in front. This thing comes out and you can move it. For me, I'll need to screw it back in over here. I can take my drive, plug it in and fix it in place. I could use this thermal pad, but for the moment it's not the case. I'm gonna monitor the temperature. If required, of course, I'm gonna plug it over here and make sure that the heat is properly dissipated from this drive. I really like the fact that we have a label for everything. It makes everything much easier. We can easily identify the GPIO pins. As a bonus, where is it? I also bought an RTC battery, why not? Let's install it. RTC, very easy to find. Once connected, I'll just need to find a way to place it. It does come with this sticky pad, but I'm not sure exactly where can I stick it. So for the moment, I'm just gonna glue it to the battery itself. And later on, I'll find a place if it does rattle too much inside. and screw everything back in. Since this case is full black, I also bought an original Raspberry Pi 5 black adapter, so it will look way nicer. If you pay a little bit of attention, right here in the back we have the button to power on, but no way to access the SD card slot. That's not so nice in my point of view. I'm gonna use this case strictly for Home Assistant, so it will be NVMe only. At this moment, I don't care so much about this fact, but pay attention if you're buying this, that it will be very difficult to change your SD card in case that something happens. On the last page of the manual, you will find two scripts that will need to be run from Raspberry Pi OS that will pre-configure the system to run with an NVMe drive. Since this system was already configured for a top hat, I already have these configurations made. I'm simply migrating from a no case to an aluminium case, so I did not need to alter anything inside. Make sure you run the scripts before closing the case, because yeah, you can't access the SD card, and only after that plug everything back in. That's it for this video. This is the Argon NEO 5 M.2 NVMe case. I hope you enjoyed it, and if so, please don't forget to like and subscribe.